Hello, my dear students. Today, under label law first paper, we will study two important topics. As you all are aware that we are studying the Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act 1946. Under this act, we will study the temporary application of model standing orders given under section 12A and interpretation of standing orders given under section 13A. So these two topics we will cover today. Section 12A of the Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act 1946 talks about the temporary application of model standing orders. This section says that notwithstanding anything contained in sections 3 to 12 for the period commencing on the date on which this act becomes applicable to an industrial establishment and ending with the date on which the standing orders as finally certified under this act come into operation under section 7 in that establishment. And the prescribed model standing orders shall deemed the prescribed model standing order shall be deemed to be adopted in that establishment. And the provisions of section 9 under subsection 2 of section 13 and section 13A shall apply to such model standing orders as they apply to the standing orders so certified. So, my dear students, here I would like to repeat this, that the prescribed model standing order shall be deemed to be adopted in that establishment, and the provisions of section 9, subsection 2 of section 13 and section 13A shall apply to such model standing orders as they apply to the standing orders so certified. And nothing contained in subsection 1 shall apply to an industrial establishment in respect of which the appropriate government is the government of the state of Gujarat or the government of the state of Maharashtra. So these two states, the Gujarat and the Maharashtra, the main issues, main point here that we must keep in our mind. And so far the interpretation of the standing orders are concerned under the Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act 1946, and these interpretation of standing orders are given under section 13A. And section 13A of the act provides that the portion relating to any application or interpretation of a standing order certified under this act can be referred to any labor court constituted under the Industrial Dispute Act 1947. So, my dear students, if any question arises as to the application or interpretation of the standing order certified under this act, any employer or workman or trade union or other representative body of the workman may refer this question, which may be related to the application or the interpretation of standing orders. This may be referred to the any one of the labor courts constituted under Industrial Dispute Act 1947 and specified for the disposal of such proceeding by the appropriate government by notification in the official gazette. And the labor code to which the question is so referred shall, after giving the parties an opportunity of being heard, decide the question, and such decision shall be final and binding on the parties. So once this question is referred to the labor code will provide an opportunity of being heard to the parties, and then will decide the question, and such a decision shall be final and binding on the parties. So one more thing I would like to quote here, that there is an important case related to the interpretation of standing orders, Motilal versus Bharat Electronics Limited. And in this case, I would like to show you the case. In this case, it was held that determination of the labor court is made final and binding on the parties. Further, it was held in the same case that the language of section 13A is not very clear. It cannot certainly be understood as creating a forum for adjudication of industrial disputes involving the application and or interpretation of standing orders. So it can not certainly be understood as creating a forum for adjudication of industrial disputes involving the application and or interpretation of standing orders. So my dear students, that is the function of the courts and tribunals constituted under the Industrial Disputes Act 1947. And the limited purpose of this section 13A is to provide a forum for determination of any question arising as to the application or interpretation of the certified standing orders as such in case either the employer or the employees entertain a doubt as to their meaning of their applicability. So my dear students, here we can say the function of the courts, the function of the tribunals which are constituted under the Industrial Dispute Act, the limited purpose of this section is to provide a forum for the determination of any question arising as to the application or the interpretation of the certified standing orders as such, and in case either the employer or the employees entertain a doubt as to their meaning or their applicability. So if the case is such, then these courts or the tribunals will which are constituted under the ID Act will just take care of this. Now, one very important, so this is all about the so far the interpretation of the standing orders under section 13A is concerned. Now we'll talk about the where there are a certain establishment on which this act doesn't apply. So under section 13B, act not to apply to certain industrial establishments given under this Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act 1946, And this section says that nothing in this act shall apply to an industrial establishment in so far as the workmen employed therein are persons to whom the fundamental and supplementary rules, civil services classification, control and appeal of the civil services rules, the civil services temporary services rules, revised leave rules, civil service regulations, civilians in defense services, their classification, their control and appeal rules, or the Indian Railway Establishment Code, or any other rules or regulations that may be notified in this behalf by the appropriate government in the official gazette apply. So nothing in this act shall apply to an industrial establishment in so far as the workmen employed therein, one person to whom the fundamental and supplementary rules, or if the civil services, the classification, control and appeal rules, and the, if the civil services related to temporary services rules, revised leave rules, civil services regulations, civilians in defense services, the classification, control and appeal rules, or the Indian Railway Establishment Code, or any other rules or regulations that may be notified in this behalf by the appropriate government in the official gazette. And my dear students, here I would like to share with you one more point, that is the appropriate government by notification in the official gazette may exempt conditionally or unconditionally any industrial establishment or class of industrial establishment from all or any of the provisions of the act. And this power of exemption to the appropriate government is given under section 14 of this Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act 1946. So I repeat, this power of exemption given under section 14 of the Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act, the appropriate government may, by notification in the official gazette, exempt conditionally or unconditionally any industrial establishment or class of industrial establishments from all or any of the provisions of this act. And this power of exemption is given under section 14 of this Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act 1946. So this is all, my dear students, for today's lecture. Quickly, we will just go for a quick look what we have covered today. We have covered the temporary application model, application of Model Standing Orders Act, and interpretation of standing orders. Temporary application model standing orders given under section 12A, and the interpretation of standing orders given under section 13A. And we have also covered today about the power to exempt. These powers are given to the appropriate government under section 14. So under section 12A, temporary application of model standing orders, we have covered that how these temporary application can be moved. And we have also talked about the interpretation of standing orders. And in interpretation of standing orders, we have just gone through that if there is any question which arises to the application and interpretation of the standing order certified under this act, any employer, workman, trade union or representative of the body of workmen may refer this question to any one of the labor courts constituted under the Industrial Dispute Act 1947 and specified for the disposal of such proceedings by the appropriate government by notification in the official gazette. And labor court to which the question is so referred shall, after giving the parties of an opportunity of being heard. The labor court will decide the question, and such decision shall be final and binding on both the parties. Then, my dear students, we have just gone through the brief of the facts of the case Motilal versus Bharat Electronics Limited 2003, and it was held in this case the determination of labor court of the labor court is made final and they would be binding on the parties. And further, it was also held that the language of section 13A is not very clear. It cannot certainly be understood as creating a forum for adjudication of industrial dispute involving the application or interpretation of the standing orders. And this is the function of the court and tribunal constituted under the Industrial Disputes Disputes Act 1947. And the limited purpose of this section 13A is to provide a forum for determination of any question arising as to the application or interpretation of the certifying standing orders. As such, in case either the employer or the employees entertain a doubt as to their meaning or their applicability. So, these topics we have covered, my dear students. Thank you so much for your patience listening. And once again, I will suggest you that whenever you are just going through these notes or PPTs, please keep a copy of BEAR Act with you to, if you have any doubt, quickly refer the BEAR Act. Thank you so much. I hope this lecture will just help you to learn the topics we have covered in the lecture. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care.